deep within the southern steppes, Russia's only Buddhist republic. It's a big change from the grey Soviet years when all religion was banned. Now temples, Buddhas and pictures of the Dalai Lama abound in Kalmykia's capital, Elistar. He's already made 3 visits here, a 4th may be a while coming. Moscow's reluctant to issue a new visa, given improving relations with China. But the last in 2004 was to bless this.
The largest Buddhist temple in Greater Europe, the Golden Abode to Buddha Shakyamuni as it's called, is visible all across the capital Elistar, and it serves as a giant centerpiece around which life in the tiny republic revolves.
And it was all the vision of one man, chess fanatic, self-made millionaire and head of the republic since 1993. Kirsan Ilyumzhinov has personally overseen Kalmykia's Buddhist renaissance.
All Buddhist temples and churches were crashed and destroyed during the Soviet period. 15 years ago, no one, and now 67 Buddhist and Christian churches, and most of them I paid from my pocket. This is my gifts.
But some argue that not all the funding was privately sourced, and that $8 million in one of Russia's poorest regions could have been better spent. But no expenses spared. Specialist painters from Tibet painstakingly decorate the temple's interior, a process that could last another 4 years. Across the republic, Kalmykian and Tibetan monks work side by side.
Buddhism is such an important part of our lives here. Every day, anyone who wants to can come to the temple and meet with any monk to talk about anything they want.
And come morning prayers, the temple is full. A blessing from a visiting Tibetan Lama draws a crowd of hundreds. A regular visitor to Kalmykia for the past 15 years, he's a fan of what Ilyumzhinov's achieved here.
He's the first president in Russia who have not only building Buddhist temple here, so he also helped building a Christian church. And he also helped building an Islamic, temple also. So that's where it's one very good example of the president of Kalmykia who helped other religions. Although he's Buddhist, he respects other religions, helped them to build their temple.
Kalmykia's religious renaissance, a genuine revival, or the price of building a presidential legacy. What is plain to see? Temples of a different kind are now also being built, hoping to fulfill the region's economic destiny. Alice Hibbert, RT Kalmykia.